Hello, anyone and everyone. I am Echo, and today we're exploring Obduction. We are here back in Kaptar, of course, as we were last time. So, you know, anybody with a relatively good memory should know that. And I'm actually going to be heading back. We're not going on the new path that we just unlocked at the end of the last episode, where we could finally go up those stairs and get to the other side of the big machine thingy. Because instead, I'm going to head back all the way over here and do something that I just thought of before starting today's little recording session, where in the last episode we did that trick with using the teleportation globe things to return that one section of Hunrath back to where it was before. But I just realized we could do the same with the other teleportation thing, which also leads back to Hunrath, and maybe find something cool. I kind of doubt it, because as we will see when I finish turning this thing and get over there in order to show you all, yeah, there isn't really anything here. It's right at the end of a you know, cliff and everything, so I highly doubt there's anything here, but nonetheless, we will give it a try. It might, you know, might prove to at least show us a cool clue to a puzzle or something. I don't know. And we've never seen the opposite side of it, unlike with the other one, where when we first came into Kaptar, the the other section had already been switched around, and so we had seen the Kaptar section that was placed in Hunrath. We haven't seen the opposite end of this because it was normal Hunrath when we first found this teleportation device. So, yeah, we're gonna do that then. I really do love how it looks when you reform the, you know, reform after the teleportation. And also the way it looks when the world's breaking down around you for the teleportation. I think it looks really nice. It's a really nice effect that they built. Also, that's one more extra long loading screen to be cut out. I'm sure anybody watching this, if anybody is keeping up with these videos, I'm sure you all appreciate me cutting those out, but oh boy, they take too long. Really hope that at some point in the future, I think right back here is where we want to go. And the machine should be. Wait a minute, nope. We want to go further up if we can, because we want to be up there. So is there... I think there is. I think there's a... Yeah, there's more wall to the right here that should lead us over there. If I'm not mistaken. Nope, that just takes us back to where we were. Okay. Because I went that way, so to get up top, I should go this way. Oh, wait, I might have to go down on the bridge, that's right. Yep. Not far enough. Boy. It's been too long since I last played this game. Well, excluding the last episode. The last episode was recorded relatively recently. But prior to that last episode, it's been a while. So, I'm still a little bit rusty on how all the teleportation and everything works. Oh, screw it. We'll go the long way around, and I might just cut it out if it takes too long. Oh, but yeah, as I was saying, I really hope they, at some point in the future, it doesn't have to be while I'm playing the game during this playthrough, but I really hope that at some point in the future, they, patch out the, you know, long loading times and the poor performance. Because as I've pointed out before, there's really no excuse for why this game should get as low a frame rate as it does. I mean, it's a gorgeous looking game, but I've played gorgeous-er looking games with a perfectly fine, smooth 60 frames per second with, you know, most of the settings at max. And this is just kinda... Oy vey. Oh wait, that's the one that leads to Moray. Oh my god. Where's the other one that leads to Kaptar? It's down in the house, in the middle of the town, right. Jeez. Okay, running all the way back. Okay, here we are. Now let's pull that lever and head on back to Kaptar. I have to press it again, because I pressed it too soon. There you go. Okay, here we are. And yeah, to finish my thought that keeps getting interrupted by crazy teleportation shenanigans, I hope that they eventually patch this game for better performance and shorter loading times. Not for the sake of my current playthrough, because by now, honestly, I'm used to it. But, you know, in the future, if I ever come back to this game, and, or anybody else who comes back to this game in the future, I would like the, experience to not be sullied by all of that stuff, which could get tiring, because as it is now, it's very easy to put up with bad performance or long loading times, because everything about the game is still new and fresh, but, you know, all the environments and all the puzzles and everything are still brand new and interesting. And, yep. Not much. Damn. There's some interesting cave drawings that I don't think were there before. But besides that, well, seems like nothing at all. Alright. Cool. And yeah, there's still no way to call the elevator down. So let's head back on over to the other side. Oh wait, wrong thing. Herder. Yep. All right, downstairs. And all the way back. Oh, that's... Oh, cool. That's 8 minutes plus of running around and getting nothing accomplished. Fantastic. Most exhilarating gameplay on YouTube ever. But if anybody is surprised by that at this point, from me, oi. You got some learning to do. Okay, where's those stairs down? Right over here. Cool. Take these around and we'll finally get on the other side of that big metallic gorge. Up here, and there they are. There's the stairs that we've all been waiting for. And there's the stairs that we can't seem for the life of us to get to come down. Which actually, they're already down a fair amount. How did I never notice that from up top? I don't know. Oh well. Okay. So what's up here? Besides more amazing music. Now, there's a thing. There's a lot of things. Oh boy. Look at down to there soon. There's actually a second staircase there I could have taken. I didn't even notice it. Oh well. Okay. So, how do we get down there? Is that... Oh! Is that a path? I think that's a path I might have missed. Oh, and there's the tree. Of course. Okay. Cool. We'll get to that soon enough. Oh boy, there's so many paths. There's so many pathways. So many new directions we can go, and I'm getting a little bit turned around. So let's go down and investigate this side here. I think this... Wait, no, that's where I saw the thing. God dang it. So where was that, I saw that smooth, like, ramp-looking path that we saw? I guess that's on the other side of... Yeah, it's right over here. But that's on the other side of the machine. That's, like, behind the machine. And we can't get there. Huh. Okay. I guess that's not the way we're supposed to go then. And then we've got that tunnel. We've got the stairways that lead up through the green section. Okay, that actually seems to be it. That actually seems to only be two pathways we can take. So let's take the tunnel, because this should go in the direction of the big windmill-like machine. And obviously has more chance of going down. Huh, this is just like the door in Hunrath, the one that's on the other side of the river. Okay, and just like that one, it's locked. Shit's locked. The game. It's another name for the Silent Hill series. Okay. That doesn't actually seem like playable game area down there. So, I guess we'll head up those stairs. It's interesting. I really was not expecting to go up with all the things that we've seen that are down that, you know, look like places we should be going. I was not expecting up to be the mandatory direction that we go next. But oh well. Let's head that way. And that's... Oh yeah, that's the dead end I already saw. This looks cool. I wonder if this is more of Murray or a new planet, or what I assume to be Murray, because I'm assuming that green jungle planet is Murray, because Murray is the only planet that they talked about in the various journals we read, and currently that planet, the green jungle planet, and Kaptar are the only two that we've found. So... Oh... Whoa... Wow... Yeah, now I have to wonder. The things that are counterweights for the bridges, were they originally gigantic fish hooks? Because that's weird. I mean, that's obviously what happened here. It looks like the... whatever that creature is, looks like a giant fish of some kind. Though... it's not exactly. I mean, it looks like it had hands, not fins, the way the bones are structured there. Especially on that one. A little bit less so on this one, but still. Yeah, it seems like it jumped up and tried to bite on the counterweight. Which means either that thing can jump really high, or there used to be ocean here that wasn't, or somebody lowered that down deliberately to try and catch it for some reason. That's really weird. I mean, honestly, the counterweight actually looks a little bit too big for that thing to bite around it. I'm sure it can open its jaw really wide, but... oh wait, actually, right in the middle of the jaw there, trying to get the pointer right on it. Yeah, right there, there's actually a section where the bottom part of the jaw can separate and split horizontally, so it could actually open its mouth up wide enough in both directions to bite down on that. I was gonna say, as far as the vertical opening of the mouth is concerned, I was going to say, as far as the horizontal opening of the mouth is concerned, doesn't look like it would be able to open up wide enough to bite down on that thing, even though it is massive. Okay. And of course, there's no saying this long-dead creature even came from this planet. That's just what I'm assuming, because it's here. Very easily could have come from a different planet and have been teleported here at some point by the aliens, whatever aliens put all this together. And there are bones of other ones there. There's another bottom jaw section. Okay. Oh, and here is a section of the shield, which will teleport us across to somewhere, and somewhere up high by the looks of it, because the verticality is also reversed whenever you teleport through the shield. So I'm just gonna get my handy-dandy notebook and mark down this teleportation spot. I believe I'm somewhere to the northeast-ish. Maybe here? Not sure. We'll maybe get a better idea once we go through. Okay. The sky is not visible. So, I'm gonna make an educated guess and put us over here on my map. Okay. Now let's put the journal away and get moving in the game again to keep the viewer interested. Yeah. Carefully calculated LPs. That's what we do here. Never boring, always exciting. Never monotone. At all. Okay. Now where the hell are we? Oh! Okay, there's that big blue section that I saw earlier. And that's where the, yes, this would actually be a little bit further south of where I put it. So, yeah, it should be right here. Let's erase the earlier line. My voice is probably a bit quiet now because I turned away from the microphone, so whoops. Oh well. Oh well. Not like you're missing out on much. Okay. Okay, no, don't lose my page, you piece of crap. Oh my god. There. Okay. Ignore that. That didn't happen. The gameplay did not stop, even for a second. Yeah, that's all dead end down there by the looks of it. Okay, so we just have to follow this path. And it goes up and up, further up. Again, not exactly the direction I was thinking we should go. Oh. Ooh, okay. That looks like it would lead to the jungle planet. Moray, or whatever its name is. Okay. I'll have to remember that's there, but I don't want to go through just yet, because I feel like I would like to complete this area first, if possible. It's gonna honestly be a little bit annoying if it's not possible. I don't like having to switch between areas to solve puzzles when avoidable. I mean, so far we've already done a little bit of that with switching back and forth between Hunrath and Kaptar in order to bring that like laser trolley car thing over, but it hasn't been too bad. Not too bad at all. Oh, and there's another one that leads somewheres. An area that looks unrecognizable. I would have to say, just by my guess, I'd have to say it's back to Moray, but can't be certain of that. Oh, hey, birds! I wasn't expecting to see any animals. That's cool. They're on the other side of the shield, though, of course, so that's great. Hmm. Just get a look out here real quick. Standing on the edge, etc., etc., playing that Metal Gear Solid 5 song. Oh, nuclear and all that, yeah. Woohoo. Okay. Trying to get an idea if there's any place we missed, because I don't want to teleport away just yet. I feel like there's stuff to be done. I mean, we still never figured out the Russian machine. We still haven't gone in the tree, obviously. So we're obviously not done with the place. That's not what I mean. But yeah. All right, let's go to this one because this one is new. I'm pretty sure the other place leads to Moray because the rocks were covered in moss and there was like colorful orange grass. This place looks entirely new, so just in order to confirm whether or not it is new, we'll take it next. Okay. Now, what? Huh. This isn't what I was expecting. Obviously, this place has been lived in by people. Anything on the rabbit's butt? Nope. Okay. No writing on the rabbit. Got it. What is all this? Lots of books. Yeah, totally. Somebody lived here, collected toys. Oh, there's a little candle in the boat. That's neat. It's actually a pretty cool setup, too. Okay. Oh, that looks important. Okay, just... no, nothing. Okay. Surprisingly, nothing important in there by the looks of it. Just seems like toy jewelry. And, this thing is... what the hell? Why is it chained up here? And how is it... the chains couldn't be holding this up. Is this thing floating and the chains are holding it down? That looks most likely because, I mean, chains don't hold things up. Chains are not rigid objects. And yet, the chains are clearly below it. And there's no chains on top. I mean, I would say if there were at least one link of chains on the top. Maybe the bottom ones were just to hold it in place so it didn't, you know, bounce all around and knock into stuff. But there's nothing holding it up from the ceiling. It's just sitting here, and as far as I can tell, I can't get the best angle because I can't get directly behind it, but it doesn't seem to be connected to the wall either. So yeah, my educated guess is going to be that this thing is floating and the chains are holding it down so it doesn't knock into the ceiling or any other stuff. Oh, those are some fancy scissors. The male and female symbol on them, looks like. Or wait, no, that's not exactly... No, that's not exactly what the male and female symbols look like. I'm not sure. Oh, there's a book we can read. We'll save that for a moment later. I want to look around the rest of the room first. Oh. Here's more books? Oh, but we can't read these ones. These are just decoration books. Oh, what's that say? Something written. Adventures in the Ages of Myst and Beyond. Oh. Oh, I think this says handwritten. I'm not good at reading cursive, and that first part there confuses me, but from here on, that's clearly the word written, so I'm gonna guess it says handwritten. It says Adventures in the Ages of Myst and Beyond, and Ages is even capitalized, so... Yeah, guess what this is. Reference to their past work. Another one. Apparently, somebody pointed out to me that, at the opening of the game, when you see that first holographic projection of the mayor, and he greets you in various different languages, one of the languages he greets you in is actually the Dani language. He says Shora, which is Dani for, hello, of course, like every other word he was saying. He was saying hello in Chinese and Russian and English and everything else. And that right there is a symbol from the Myst games as well. I'm actually currently playing through Uru, which is the MMO that is unfortunately kind of dead right now. But I'm playing through that game in my off time, and that is a symbol from that game. I can't quite remember off the top of my head what that symbol is for of significance in the actual game world, but I know that the player group called the Guild of Writers use that as their symbol, or at least something very similar. I'm not gonna make any definitive statements here, but let's see what that says on the back. Yeah, Inkworks. From caverns miles beneath the New Mexico desert, the Dani ruled an empire that lasted 10 millennia. They wrote linking books that allowed them to span universes, ignoring the primitive humans that infested the surface. But the glory of Dani was brought low mere centuries ago, and their ages were left empty and abandoned. Until now. Called to the desert, we have found our way down to Dani. Its secrets are in our hands, and its future is ours to determine. The next chapter of Dani is unwritten. In 1993, Cyan Inc. introduced us to the surreal worlds of Myst and the Dani. Now you can make your own journeys of exploration and adventure through the ages. Discovery-focused mechanics, play in modern or historical Dani, unlimited possible environments. I love the idea of having other ways for people to tell stories in the Myst universe. Richard Rawa Watson, Cyan Inc. And there's the Cyan logo, and powered by Fate. I'm guessing that's the Fate engine, which might be the name of the engine some of the Myst games were made of. I don't know. I don't remember the names of the engines they were built in. But that's really cool. Obviously, this isn't even a subtle reference in the slightest. This is just flat out, hey, look, we worked on Myst. And that's cool. That's cool with me. I mean, it's kind of funny, though, if you think about it, that, apparently, in the universe of Obduction, the Myst video games and books existed as fictional properties. That's kind of funny. Okay, and oh, there's just straight up the Myst linking book with... Oh, let's not do that just yet. I wanted to look at the side first. No, no, damn it. Pick it up. Okay, we can't just look at the side. But it says Myst. And, oh, that's weird. I'm going from right to left, but we can't actually open up the front. It only opens up the back. Okay, that's unfortunate, but that's okay. And what is all this, then? I don't know. It's lots of computer circuitry. Looks like a motherboard. Well, I guess that'd be a motherboard in the back, actually, and this would be something else. But we can't actually interact with it. That's a little weird. Hmm. Yeah, all we can do is open and close the book. I bet more dedicated people than me will probably scan this at a super high resolution and probably find some code written in the barcode thing there and stuff down here maybe, and those look like some numbers, so who knows? No, I'm trying to... Okay, right-click, thank you. Yeah, that's cool. That's all very, very cool. And what did the side of this say? Cerberus B.S. Wolf. Okay. I don't know what that one is. Okay. There's some people. Cool. I'm guessing all of these paintings were written by... Or, not written. Drawn by whoever lived here. But, I don't know, the art style seems a little bit different between this one painting and all the others. It's probably just because of the people. That's the only painting with people in it. The people are sort of offsetting it and making it look like a different art style when it's not really. Okay, note. Array larval notes by CF. Takes about 3 to 5 days for single array larvae to change colors after being moved to a new surface. Pulsing stops immediately upon removal from Captar, induced by polyarchs. Cloning has been extremely easy, like potatoes easy. Organics. Plant fiber, yellow, bone, light yellow, array, encrustment, green. Metals, gold, pink. Copper, red, orange, titanium, orange, silver, red, aluminum, red, orange. Tech, Mofang Tech, Magenta, Valane, Extrusions, Near White, Stone, Granite, Captar, Teal Blue, Sandstone, Hunrath, Light Blue, Sore Stone, Mofang, Deep Blue, Shale, Marae, Very Light Blue, plus Polyarch Pods, always purple. To do, I'm curious about the effect of combining various base surface. Still a bit odd, experimenting with the life forms. The light they emit is handy given our limited supply of diesel fuel. Okay. Let's take a picture of that one. Intentionally this time, because that's a lot of information to write down, which would take long and I'd have to cut it out. So to save myself a little bit of time with the editing, I'm just gonna leave it. What's this thing? Well, that's pretty cool. Obviously, whatever it used to be was broken apart. Huh. I kind of doubt it, but that might be important, so let's just do that. And this thing, oh, it's a little diagram of one of the lasers. Interesting. Sitting on top of a weird burrito-looking thing. Okay. We've still got a pathway to go to take us to the entire rest of the area, I presume. Unless this actually... I don't know, now that I'm looking at the red rock that's around most of this place, it actually might be Hunrath that we're in. We might be in a previously inaccessible area. Not sure why the rocks looked so blue when we were here before when we used this thing. I don't know. But anyway, so we have got that path to go down, and we've got this little journal to read. But we'll have to do that in the next episode because I am completely out of time, so I will see you all later. Hope you've enjoyed it. Buh-bye.
Thank you.